بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. إخوتي في الله، حياكم الله. اليوم نأخذ درسا من صفة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Today we're going to take a class from the description of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وكنا في باب صبره صلى الله عليه وسلم على الأذى. We were in a chapter of his patience upon harassment. فعندي سؤال، هل هناك فرق بين أذية وضرر؟ Is there a difference between the two, ضرر والأذى؟ نعم، في فرق. أذية is annoyance، ضرر is harm. نعم. هل يتأذى ربنا سبحانه وتعالى؟ Does Allah become annoyed and harassed? Does Allah become harassed, annoyed? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعْنَهُمُ اللَّهُ. Those that annoy Allah and His Messenger, لَعْنَهُمُ اللَّهُ. The curse of Allah. أما الضرر, أما as for harm, no. No harm comes to Allah. نعم. لَنْ يَضُرُّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. نعم. والله سبحانه وتعالى يقول كما ذكرنا لن يضركم إلا أذى. يا سورة يا عبد الصبور، لن يضركم إلا أذى. هذا في سورة آل عمران. They won't harm you anything except annoyance. So there's a difference. لن يضركم إلا أذى. They won't harm you anything except annoyance. نعم. هناك فرق. وannoyance أكثره ما تسمع. نعم. Annoyance, most of it is what you hear. نعم. It's annoyance. يسخرون بك. They make small of you. They laugh at you. It's noise. نعم. ما يضر. It really doesn't harm you. It just annoys you. نعم. وهذا الذي نلقى من أهلنا ومن أولادنا وممكن من جيراننا أو لا أننا نصبر عليها. نعم. ما لكم. That which we sometimes encounter from our families and our children or our neighbors is annoyance. It's not harm. نعم. You have the capability to stay poised. You have the capability. نعم. It just takes patience. Harm and detriment is different. فَلَا بُدَّ أَنَّنَا نَتَحَلَّى بِالصَّبْرِ. We beautify ourselves with patience. نعم. نتحلى به. Like it's a nice coat. Like it's a good garment that you put on. نعم. وبعدنا قد خلعوها. Some people, they take off that coat of patience. Man, I'm not dealing with this. لا, you have to deal with it. هذا أهلك. هذا أولادك. That's your children. That's your family. أبد. You have to. لا تقلع. هذا لباس الصبر. نعم. The clothing of صبر. Don't take it off. Don't take it off. البسه خير لك. It's better for you. فنقرأ حديثنا اليوم وهو حديث عظيم مبينا صبره صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm going to read a hadith today. It's a great hadith explaining the patience of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وأذيته من نهية الدعوة. نعم. The annoyance and harassment that the Prophet had to deal with is him trying to explain Islam and spread Islam. Now, it's not like he's trying to build a house or he's in the soup, he's trying to buy stuff, he's competing, buying and selling. No, that's the thing. It's in spreading Islam. Well, hadith al-Bukhari. And Aisha radiallahu anha. بخاري ومسلم جزاك الله خير. أنها حدثته. She said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, هل أتى عليك يوما كان أشد من يوم أحد؟ Did a day come to you that was harder on you or more severe on you than يوم أحد? Did a day come to you harder than that? نعم. طيب when is يوم أحد؟ متى يوم أحد؟ قبل الهجرة بعد الهجرة؟ نعم أكيد. No wars occurred before Hijra. بعد الهجرة. نعم. أيهما أول؟ البدر أو أحد؟ بدر. نعم. بدر before أحد. ما حصل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم أحد؟ What happened to the Prophet يوم أحد؟ Hold on. You know Harun. هذا. ما happened to the Prophet يوم أحد؟ ما هذا؟ يوم أحد. The day of أحد. What happened to the Prophet? She said, did a day come to you that was hard and more severe on you than يوم أحد? What happened to the day يوم أحد? It's better. What happened to the Prophet? Yeah. عندك. They broke his tooth. What tooth did they break of the Prophet? What's the name of it? رباعية. ما معنى الرباعية? Where is that رباعية? أحسنت. مس مكانت. حمزة. نعم. These two in the front is called ثنايا. عندك ثنايتان. There's two in the front. The two next to it, رباعيتان. The two on the next. But the ones that happened to the Prophet weren't on the top, on the bottom. His bottom, رباعية. نعم. His bottom tooth. From his front teeth. Allah Allah. But who would, if you got a tooth knocked out, if you got a tooth knocked out, would you like to be your front tooth or your side tooth? No, yeah, you don't want your front tooth to get knocked out. I'm not gonna die. I'm a shadeed alay. Who النبي محمد صلوات الله وسلام عليه, the Prophet of Allah, knocked out his front tooth. Yeah. Well, what happened also? What else happened to him? Should Jeffy or Ritzy? Nah, they broke his, they wounded his head. Nah. Has Salad done? Did the blood come out? Kathir and Qaliyah, did a lot of blood come out? A lot. To the point they couldn't stop it. They had to take a hasir, they had to take a straw, burn the straw, and get the ashes and just put the hot ashes on his head to get it stopped. And he was hit hard. Nah. So now Aisha knows that day. She was there that day. Nah. She's asking, did a day come harder than that? Nah, Makula had them in. Shafaqatiha ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's just from her concern and care for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Compassion. Qala laqad qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laqad laqitu min qawmiki ma laqitu. I have experienced from your people min Quraysh what I experienced. Wa kana ashad ma laqitu minhum yawm al-aqaba. And the worst that I met for them was Jamu Aqaba, yani Jamratul Aqaba bimina. Naam. Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fil muwasim, yani mawsim al-hajj, yamshi ila mina wa yad'u an-nas ila al-islam. Al-qaba'il, qabila ba'da qabila ba'da qabila, yad'uhum ila islam, wa lam yastajibu lah. Oh, ihta sabr ya akhwan. Ihta sabr. Ma nastati an namshi fi al-shara' wa nad'u an-nas. Nahnu da'at. He said the worst day that I met was Yawm al-Aqaba, meaning Aqaba to Jamra during the time of Hajj. Na'am. At Mina, the Prophet used to go before he made Hijrah, while he was a prophet. Na'am. And when the people came to Hajj, he would call them to Islam, tribe by tribe. What would he say? Kan yaqul, man yu'wini, man yansuruni. Now, he was looking for a tribe, man yu'wini, who's going to protect me? Who's going to aid me? Hatta uballigha kitab rabbi, so I can convey the message of my Lord. But he can't do it by himself. He needs protection. وهذا يأتي من حديث جابر وهو عند أصحاب سنن، قال جابر رضي الله عنه، وجابر من الأنصار، والأنصار هم القبيلة الذين استجابوا له. The Ansar, they're the tribe, they had came to Hajj one year, and they saw this man, the Prophet, calling them to Islam and said, who's going to protect me? They did it. So they went back and they gathered up and they came back and they gave him bail. That's how the whole thing started. قال جابر رضي الله عنه مكث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 سنين يتبع الناس في المنازل. The Prophet spent 10 years in Mecca following people at their homes. وفي عكاظ ومجنة. These are two markets. He used to go to these two markets calling people. والمواسم بمينا. At the times of Hajj at Mina. These are the places the Prophet would go and call people to Islam. يقول من يؤويني من ينصرني حتى أبلغ رسالة ربي وله الجنة. Whoever's going to protect me, who's going to help me so I can convey the message of my Lord, and for him is Jannah. So he would do this over and over, and nobody would answer his call. فكان أبو طالب عمه يحفظه يعني يمنعه. His uncle Abu Talib would protect him from the Adiyah of Quraysh. ولكن لما مات لم يجد ذاك المنع. زادت ماذا الأذية. When his uncle Abu Talib died, he didn't find anybody protect him. Rather, the harassment increased. The harassment increased. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling Aisha, this day, كان يوم عقبة, كان يدعو الناس القبائل, لم يستجيبوا له أحد. فذهب إلى طائف. مل من أهل مكة. He despaired of the people of Mecca. They're not going to answer. He went to طائف. And when you go to a قبيلة, you're going to go to the head of the قبيلة. You're going to go to the sheikh of the قبيلة. وهيحاول يقنعه. He's going to try to convince him. Have your tribe follow me, aid me. قال إذ أردت نفسي على ابن عبد ياليل ابن عبد كلال فلم يجبني إلى ما أردت. He went to his head of this tribe وعرض نفسه من طلب منهم النصرة والمنع. He went to these people and he requested from them protection and commitment. They didn't give him what he wanted. That's what he wanted. بل رضخوا ورجموا في الحجارة على رجليه صلى الله عليه وسلم. Instead, they stoned him. They threw rocks at him. And they afflicted his leg. حتى سال الدم. His legs bled. قال فانطلقت وأنا مهموم على وجهي. أي انطلقت على وجهي في جهتي وأنا مهموم. And then he left from them. وهو مهموم. ما معنى مهموم؟ يعني he's غاية من الحزن. He's very depressed. يعني it's so good. Imagine if you went to my place calling. You're by yourself. أنت وحدك. من معه؟ Who's with him? لا أحد. أمر النفر من هنا وأمر النفر من هنا قليل. Maybe one person we leave here, but he needs a group of people to protect him. فانطلقت وأنا مهموم على وجهي. And he went just straight ahead, going back to the area of Mecca. مهموم. وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحزن. ولقد نعلم أنك يضيق صدرك. بما يقولون. We know that it bothers you, the things that they say about you. We know that it bothers you. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. It's difficult. It's difficult. قال فلم أستفق إلا وأنا بقرن الثعالب. I didn't wake up. I didn't come out of what I am from this depression and everything. لم أفق. Until he was at this mountain. القرن هو جبل صغير. قرن يعني جبل الثعالب. It's between طائف ومكة. يعني ذهب ذهب مسافة وهو مهموم. He went a long distance. And until he just realized, you know, that he went a distance, all that time he was depressed. حزين, مهموم, حيران, confused. قال فرفعت رأسي فإذا أنا بسحابة قد أظلتني, يعني أظلتني أكثر من العادة, أكثر من العادة. He said, I don't realize, I raised my head, except that I'm under a cloud, it had covered me, it shaded me. Meaning it shaded me more than normal. The cloud shade, but this cloud shaded him while he was walking and walking, still realized he's in the shade. So he raised his head and he sees that he's under a cloud. فنظرت فإذا فيها جبريل. I looked and in the cloud was جبريل. عليه الصلاة والسلام. فناداني, he called me. فقال إن الله قد سمع قول قومك لك. Really, Allah heard the statement of your people, what they said to you. وما ردوا عليك, and how they replied to you when you presented yourself to them. وقد بعث إليك ملك الجبال. Allah has sent to you the angel that's in charge of the mountains. لتأمره بما شئت فيهم. So that you can command him whatever you want in these people that reject. فناداني ملك الجبال. And the Prophet said, so the angel of the mountain called me. ناداني ملك الجبال. فسلم علي, he gave me the salams. ثم قال يا محمد, he said, oh Muhammad. قال ذلك فيما شئت. That is whatever you want. إن شئت أطبق عليهم الأخشبين. If you want, I will take these two mountains and crumble it on them. الأخشبين and the جبلين. وأطبق بما يغطيهم تماما. It's going to cover them totally. إن يحيطهم من كل جوانب. هذا مطبقة. That is going to cover them completely. هذا معنى إطباق. It's going to cover them completely from every angle. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بل أرجو أن يخرج الله من أصلابهم من يعبد الله وحده ولا يشرك به شيئا. He said, rather than that, instead of dropping these two mountains on them, I hope that Allah will bring from them, from their offsprings, bring from them those that worship Allah alone and don't associate any partners with them. وَقَدْ حَصَلْ كَمَا أَرَادْ كَمَا رَجَعْ. And it occurred just like he wanted after he went to Medina, after all that. الحصر. فهذا يا إخوتي في الله, هذا يبين صبره صلى الله عليه وسلم. This explains some of the difficulty that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went through. ودعوة إلى الله يحتاج إلى صبر. دعوة, calling people to Islam, يحتاج صبر. ويقولون من جهل شيئا, من جهل شيئا عاداه. Whoever's ignorant of something, he goes against it. So when people are ignorant, the main reason, أكبر سبب عدم دخول الناس في الإسلام والطاعة, أكبر سبب هو الجهل. The biggest reason people don't enter Islam, the biggest reason is ignorance. Is ignorance. فما بالك كما يذكر بعض أهل العلم, ما بالك إذا أضيف إلى الجهل الكبر, البخل, الشهوة, وغير ذلك من أمراض القلوب. The main reason why people don't obey Allah is because of ignorance. That's the main reason. And what about if this ignorance is coupled with arrogance, greed, jealousy, and envy. It makes it worse. It makes it worse. نعم. فالمفروض من الدعاة إلى الله الصبر. نعم. الداعي إلى الله يتحمل. When somebody is called to Islam, you have to be patient. هذا ميدان الصبر. This is the field where you have to be patient. تصوروا يا إخوة، واحد يقول أنه يريد أن يكون طبيب. Somebody says that they want to be a doctor. وهو في الطوارئ، يعني هو جديد، كان في الكلية، تخرج من الكلية الآن، هو في طوارئ تطبيق عملي. نعم. He was in the college, he wants to be a doctor. Now he's finished, he graduated, he's in emergency room. نعم. He's actually getting the practical, you know. He's gonna put it into practice now. نعم. فيرى أحد يموت ما يهم يتحمل يشوف الدم. الله المستعان، مات ويبكي والموت والطفل مات والمرأة مات والدم. قال ما أنت أهل لهذا الدم. ممكن تريد تكون ميكانيك أو صاحب كمبيوترات، أنت ما أهل لهذا. نعم. So when he's in the emergency room, he sees blood, he can't handle it, a woman died, a baby died, he's crying like, you took the wrong profession. Maybe you want to be a mechanic or IT. Maybe that's a little better for you. This place is going to have to be death on a regular basis. Blood. You have people coming, you have to get their legs cut off. Some people have to get their fingers cut off. You have to go back and tell the family that their father passed away. What is wrong with you? Nah. Well, I can have the da'wah ila Allah. Nah. You have to have thick skin. الجل لابد تكون تخشن. نعم. Don't be upset that somebody talked about you or somebody said something about you. And that comes with it. That comes with it. وكذلك يا إخوة، هذا الأمر يحتاج إلى إخلاص. نعم. يحتاج حرص. نعم. It needs حرص. It needs sincerity. It needs حرص. It needs somebody who loves that, somebody who's concerned. واحد يهمه أحوال الناس ونجاة الناس. همه هذا. Somebody, it concerns him, the conditions of the people and the salvation of the people and the people are saved in this world and the hereafter. ما هو صح واحد يريد أتعرف على العلماء وأعرف العلماء وأنزل عندهم. It's not just somebody, I love the علماء, I want them to know me, I want to get close to them. هذا ما هو صح الدعوة. أنا داعي إلى الله. لا، أرفع من هذا يا أخي. أرفع من هذا. فكل من يريد أن يدعو إلى الله، خلي نصب عينيك أن تنصر دين الله، لا تنصر أصحابك ولا حتى ولا شيخك، تنصر دين الله. نعم. نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من يؤويني، من يؤويني، من ينصرني وهو مستقوات إسلام بأدائي إلى الله. That his intention be that he wants to aid the religion of Allah, not aid his partners or even aid his sheikh. Put all that on the side. He wants to aid the religion of Allah. That's what's in his mind. He doesn't do with no people, no nothing. Religion of Allah. نعم. فأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يعيننا على حاله. فالذي يخرب النوايا, that which messes up, ويفسد النوايا, النيات, that which messes people's niyah up and corrupts it, هو طلب الدنيا في الدعوة. That somebody would try to use the da'wa for the purpose of money. نعم. The purpose of money. نعم. يجعل الإسلام سلما للمال. It makes the da'wa in Islam a ladder to get up to money. نعم. فما ستجد أبشرك ما ستجد الصبر. You're not going to have any patience. I'll give you the good news. You're not going to find patience. You're not going to find it. ما ستجد نشاطا ولا حرصا. You're not going to find that you're energetic and that you're eager. لا أنت بعد المال. والمال يزيد وينقص. Sometimes it comes, sometimes it doesn't come. نعم. ولكن صاحب الدائرة الله ما دام هناك يعني حاجة إلى نشر الدين نشر العلم. نعم. هو في شأن. نعم. دائرة الله as long as there's a need. نعم. As long as there's a need for people to learn and there's a need for people to understand, that's what he's, that's his wazifa. هذا شأنه. That's what he's about. نعم. فكثير من الناس أسأل الله يصلح أحوال الناس مالوا إلى الدنيا. A lot of people have inclined to the dunya. تتعجب أن المساجد في هذا الزمان متاجر. متجر. The masjid is just a way to make money. That's all the masjid is. In many places, the masjid is just a way to make money. نعم. وداعي إلى الله. البضاعة البضاعة على الرفوف هم الناس هم أنتم. نعم أنتم من البضاعة. The items of merchandise that are sold on the shelf, they're you. You all are merchandise. You're the ones being sold. You all. نعم يأخذ أموالكم. نعم they take your money. They play on you. They play on your sympathy. نعم they play on your love for Islam. نعم والله صلى الله أن يصلح الحال. نعم صلى الله عليه وسلم الحال. هذا درسنا الليلة. كان إنما نسمع من هذه التعب الذي لقيه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله يستحي على نفسه أن يكون همه ما. When we hear this difficulty that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went through, somebody would be embarrassed that his concern with dawah was money. You see all this ta'ab that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went through? Well, what's that Islam ilayna? Islam has reached us. Na'am, adda al-amana. Na'am, he did his job. Na'am, it's reached us. We're the proof. We're living proof. Na'am, that reached us, Safi. Na'am. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taraktukum ala al-bayda, layluha ka nahariha, la yuzigu anha illa. I left you on clear whiteness, meaning it's totally preserved. The night of it is like the day of it. It's totally clear. Nobody goes away from it except he's destroyed. نعم. وَهَلْ يَسْتَحْيِي مِنْ نَفْسِي. He should be embarrassed for himself. فَيَطْلُبْ مِنْ هَذَا مَالًا. نعم. That he's just trying to trace money. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كُسِرَتْ رَبَاعِيَّتُهُ مِنْ أَجْلِ هَذَا وَسُجَّ فِي رَأْسِهِ مِنْ أَجْلِ هَذَا. The prophet, his tooth was broke because of this. His head was wounded because of this. Now it reached you. The baton reached you in your hand to take it off. And you're like, hold up. I ain't giving it up until I get it. That's it. Yeah. Allah, Allah, ya ikhwan. La bil annana nakhaf Allah. Kam muni'a an-nas. Kam ya'ani muni'a an-nas bisabab du'ati ila Allah. Ma yajtahidu. How many people suffer? They don't learn. They're bored. Because of the dua to Allah. Now, had in the sihali, awwalan. This advice is for me, awwalan, first and foremost. How many people suffer? How many communities have been broken up? How many brothers that have been, yani, together, loved ones, and split up? Is it because fulan and fulan, they can't get along? Nah. La bud anana nansur deen Allah. Da'na kullu hadhihi mashakil. All these problems, put them on the side. Nansur deen Allah, aid the religion of Allah, i'la kalimatullah. We have to make the word of Allah the highest in the land. فهذه هي المطلوب بالدعوة إلى الله. ماذا نريد بالدعوة إلى الله؟ What do we want when we have دعوة إلى الله? What do we want? نريد أن ينتشر طاعة الله. We want obedience of Allah to spread to the land. ليس أن مسجدك يكبر. Oh, not that your name is big or your masjid is big. No, that obedience to Allah spreads through the land. So one can masjid al kabir al amsagir, whether your masjid is big or small, whether you're known or not, aham min adh kulli. More important than all that, that the obedience of Allah spreads through the land and people learn Islam. Nah. Ask Allah and yuslih ala jami'an. Ask Allah to help us all. نكتفي بهذا القدر سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك